Alright, what's up, fuckers? We're gonna give this another go here, round two. This time we're looking at Skilsaw. Classic $4 purchase. I got this thing for on account of her being right fuckered. So this is the first tool I've kind of gonna have into and see if I can fix her up. Honestly, judging purely by the condition of the blade, we can see that all the cutting tips are actually in fairly good shape. No chips, they're not really worn down that far, so at least the blade's in a good shape, even though there's some rust on her, but that might be a good sign there. It looks like it's been used a bit, but yeah, still reasonably sharp. I'll probably still take a file to these, grind them down, get them sharp. But for now, that could be a decently good indicator. So we're gonna have into her, see what the innards look like. There was quite a bit of shmoo locked up in this fan, so we'll get some of that out. See what she's made of, and hopefully get her back running. I got another power cord that I can tear off of an old Makita reciprocating saw that I think would work pretty well for this guy, but we'll see. Yeah, I got a few cords lying around here that probably do the job. But yeah, getting into the specs, looks like 120 volts AC. I don't know if you can see this, probably not. I got this fancy stadium lighting, which is a headlamp. Yeah, it's bomb. Yoshi has some of this good. Fucking getting there. Let's see, so if you can read that, yeah, we got, so 120 volts AC, 25 to 60 hertz, interesting. So it could work in Europe or here, apparently, we'll see. 10 amps draw, that's pretty big, and it's boasting 4600 RPM. Yeah, so I still don't have really tools to measure RPM, but we'll get there sometime, so I'm gonna have into it. Yeah, so just right off the bat, looking at this thing, looks like we got some wing nut here for adjusting the kilter, and then a nice, pretty cool kind of levered bolt action there for adjusting the depth of cut. Both still working, but again, to look kind of in the fan, the innards, and you can see there's quite a bit of shmoo in there. So hopefully we can get some of that out. But yeah, for now I'm gonna try getting into these guys, take off all this extra shit, and then yeah, we'll might not be able to get that off actually. We shall see. It looks like it's pinned in there, and I still, as you saw from the last video, I don't have much to do about pins. But yeah, we'll get into the innards here. Okay, we got the outskirts off, and can take a look at this part. Really interesting molding here, actually. This contains the foregrip and the trigger section coming around here. And we can see it's marked a number 4. Which I've just learned is low density polyethylene. So reasonably sturdy, especially for how thin this part is. Actually, really good molding on it. Feels pretty good. Pretty sturdy, no cracks at all in it. Yeah, pretty straightforward, but getting into the electricals here, you can see it's cursed by the carbohydrate foam, getting shmoo everywhere. Managed to pack itself down into the crack, which is not so. As for the switch, you can see it's got a dead man's lock on here, so it's like a safety, almost, pretty much. It won't go until she goes. Really strong spring detent on that. Kind of hard to click the switch, but it feels reasonably meaty. It's kind of its own separate part here. Really dirty. Just filled with shmoo. And we can see it's getting shmoo back up and all the way back in there. No bellows on her at all. So yeah, kind of chintzy. On something like this, I really would have liked to see bellows on there, but product of Mexico, ETN, yeah, some, let's see. So we got power going into there, it's doing all the switching for the motor, all kind of internal there, and it's going into the motor housing, so let's get in there, see what she's doing. Now this part's a little weird to me. I got the back of the fan housing off. So this is where all the airflow would be going down in to cool down the commutator and disperse heat from the motor. And they've got two little, I'm not really sure what that's made of, little pop-out shock absorbers. Butylene maybe? No. Not rubber. Might be, yeah, I'm not sure. They got two little shock absorbers pushing right down on to the brush holders. And full of shit. Which seems a little odd. We wouldn't expect any force this way. Because we're pushing in this way. It's moving pretty fast. Maybe just vibration dampeners? Not super sure about that. You can see it's chock full of this carbohydrate foam. And this bearing wasn't fucked before. I mean, you can see she's had quite a few rodeos. I don't know. This bearing's gotta be fucked. If we can get it out, I don't have bearing splitters or pullers or anything, so if we can't get that out, I'll probably try to replace it. And we'll test it and stuff too, but looks like, yeah, so these are the two brush holders here attaching to the commutator down in the middle. Power goes in there, must come up down the side. Let's try to pull the motor off. Ooh, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. We're in her. Just kind of pop right off. Oh, fuck me, gone forever. Oh, got a little not shielded, guarded. I don't know, caged. Yeah, caged screw right there. That's kind of handy. Would have been gone to the wasteland if I hadn't. Wow. Okay, now we're seeing it. Looks like this commutator. Ooh. Nasty. Take a look at the black grease coming off of there, right where the commutators come. I guess that's a lubricant. But yeah, we got a fucked up bearing somewhere in there. And that attaches. Yeah, directly. There we are. Big fan in there. A little rusty. So she'd been wet before. But we got pretty nice field windings. Kind of small motor, to be honest. I would have expected a little bit more mass on these magnets. Yeah, permanent magnets, right? I had the little magnet paper stuff, but fucking lost it. Gone to the wasteland. I probably chucked it in the envelope on accident. Got a little bushing here. Yeah, and so this stuff comes off the off the sparkers, the the brushes, yeah. So this comes off the brushes, and yeah, we got a bit of rust in her. Not a great sign, but we can see that she's been used right proper, because there's a lot of grease there. And looking down at the pinion end of things, we can see that all the grease on there is just cooked. It's all black and nasty. Pinion itself, bushing gone forever. Fuck. Got it. Yeah, pinion has seen some use. Little sharp edges. I don't know how much this you guys can see. Not a lot is the answer. Focus, you fuck. But yeah, you'll have to take my word for it. They're pretty sharp edges, and a couple of them getting a little dull. Yeah, so she's been used right proper, but we already knew that. Moving on to the backside. Let's see if I can get this out of there. Pop those guys out so they're not lost forever. There we are. Held in place by four. Those screws, so far all the screws have been the same exact kind. Well, we got a different thread on there for that one, makes sense. But same head, which is actually really handy. It makes servicing it kind of easy. I don't have to change my bits. Bushing goes with the commutator. All right, so looking at this guy, looks like we have two. Yeah, so power comes in here, gets directed up to the brushes. Honestly, it looks like servicing these brushes is going to be a pain in the ass. I don't really know how to get these things out of there. Hard to say. I wonder if you just go at her. Oh yeah, they just pop right out. Okay. Just plastic brush holders. Nothing fancy, but we could see that there are all sorts of gummed up. All kinds of shmoo on there. Cheap. Chintzy. And they're getting pretty low. I don't see. It's not immediately obvious how we would switch these out. Probably just replace this whole thing, if I had to guess, but. Yeah, I don't know. Greasy. Look at that black crap coming off of there. Nasty. It's almost like oil. Like, it's been greased. Yeah, gross. We'll take a look at the next one. Pop that guy out. Decent lead connector is interesting. It's like a pin, male-female joint in there. But yeah, same deal for this one. Chock full of grease and shmoo. Yeah, so the rear, what I thought was the rear bearing, fell out of there. It's not a bearing. I was wrong, it's just a big bushing spacer. So the rear, let's see, let me clean it off a sec. Yeah. So they got a bushing on either side of it, looks like. This guy fell out of there. And that would go right on there. It's a little, spring bushing? I don't know what the fuck those are called. It's not flat, so it pushes a little bit. We can see still decent fitment, honestly. A little more wobble in there than I would like. But yeah, fairly decent so far. So that spins in there, and this holds the back of the commutator so it doesn't fly right out at you. Dirty, full of shmoo, but it still looks to be in decent shape. Usually, I think nowadays we see a big bearing in the end of that, but I guess this does the trick. You could just see the carbohydrate foam fucking everywhere. Gets into everything. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stick to metal. Yeah, nasty. I'll have to clean that up, but looking in there, field windings, fairly good shape. They put some epoxy in there, but we can see a couple of the strands are just floating off in the breeze there. Epoxy over here, but yeah, this, I guess, is really just that one strand is just fucking off, so I might stick some stuff in there. Yeah, otherwise, in good shape. I'm not seeing anything. I'll have to clean those off as well. They got some shmoo back in there. But yeah, otherwise, pretty good. Power goes right in, so the switch does all the thinking up in there. Now, getting into the fun of her. This is where we'd see the gearbox. Looks just like a tiny, tiny, like one step reduction in there. So let's try to get that out. Now, call me a dumbass, but it doesn't look like we can get in this away. And I do not see a blade lock. A stopper for the blade. I'm not really sure how to get this blade off. Maybe we need, do we need to have the commutator sitting in there to lock it up? Maybe that's it, yeah. Oh, okay, so we just need this guy in there. Looks to be a fairly, almost one-to-one gear ratio. This box right here looks like there's just a small reduction in there, mostly to absorb the push, but I don't know, hard to say until we get in there. And I think I gotta take the blade off and come in from the other end. Oh, shit. Nice. Oh, well, it's not a thread. Shit. Yeah, it's lifting up, so it's not threaded. Whoopsies. Is that? I wonder if that's. Yeah. Attach this pin back here. And these might have been pressed in. Kind of looks like they were. Well, I ain't gonna be able to do fuck all about that one. Yeah, no way. It's worth a shot, but yeah, no. Look at that amount of give, though. Seems like the shaft is, it's still connected. No, this is, yeah, it's not the shaft. The shaft goes in there. No, yeah, it is. Does that mean the blade's gonna be just wobbling? No, because it tightens down. Okay. Yeah, so that's fine. So I thought this movement here, this give, would be bad, but I'm pretty sure that will get taken up by these guys. Slot in there, clamp down on it. Should be fine, I think. Or I'm just totally wrong, which, you know, wouldn't be the first time. Yeah, I don't really care about that shmoo. I mean, yeah, I guess I'll try to get some of it out while I got her most of the way off, but not really a big deal. Yep, well, so it goes. I don't have a shop, so we're gonna get her back together and see if she chooses. I'll replace that cord. Shouldn't be too bad there. I think it's just easy, snip, snip, snip. It'd be fine. Let's get it. All right, well, I got this old Makita reciprocating saw, and she's right proper fucked. Well, most of it's still actually pretty good, but it needs a new switch, and there's some debauchery going on up here. There's some stripped out stuff on the front of her. And I got the Craftsman reciprocating saw, so I paid, once again, $4 for this thing, but the cord's still good, so I think we're gonna, kinda still good. I don't know what's up with that, that ain't me. God, fucking, they like chicken's tape. Shit's nasty, man. Turns into literal goo. God, fucking disgusting. This looks like somebody just keeping some spare tape on hand. And it doesn't look like it's really around anything. Yeah. She's fine. So we're gonna try to take this cord off the Makita and stick her onto the reciprocating saw. Well, there she be, all back together again. New power cord installed. Had to cut her down a little bit to size to fit in there, but honestly, she'll fucking go. Soldered her up. Let's give her the run, eh? See how she fucking juges. Contact. And will she go? Oh, fuck yeah. Hell yeah, she fucking goes. I got neighbors asleep, and it is currently 12:22 a.m., so I'm gonna test that out tomorrow, eh?